What's up YouTube? Those of you who've been following the channel for a while might remember the video I made exactly 1 year ago about my then EDC bag, which was the MagSatch by the company Nutsec. And while that was a great bag for the time being, and I would still recommend it wholeheartedly, there was always one feature that was lacking for me, and that was some kind of internal organization, especially for the main compartment. Well, that is true in part because I tend to carry a lot of camera gear nowadays, but that is certainly not something that everyone has to worry about. And it's also not a fault of the MagSatch 11 that it didn't have that feature, because it was never intended to be a camera bag in the first place. But for this year, I decided to try out something else, which is this, the Bowery, made by the company Ohna. It's very similar in size overall, but offers a bit more depth compared to the MagSatch 11. Both are made from leather and wax canvas and look amazing. The Ohna Bowery, however, is actually a camera bag, but sadly, it comes with just one measly divider. Luckily, I already own a ton of camera bags, so I was able to pony up a divider for better separation. Before we go into the actual contents of the bag though, just a quick side note on the whole man bag situation. I labeled this my minimalist EDC bag for a reason. I only use this when I'm out and about, and going easy and lightweight is the name of the game. So if I wanted to go on a hike or a longer day trip, I would ditch this immediately and go for my EDC backpack. So the goal with this bag is to carry as many important items as I can, while artificially limiting myself to a very confined space in order to keep it as lightweight as possible, and really focus in and think about which items I really need for the day and which items I can do without. Another reason for me to go with something like this small bag instead of a backpack, especially during the summer months, is that it doesn't matter how good the ventilation system of any backpack is, I will have sweat building up on my back like nobody's business. So that's fine for me if I'm going out on a hike or whatever, but if I'm just going to a restaurant or a cafe or whatever, that's just something I don't need. And by only having a small bag dangling around my shoulder or across my back, that's a problem that I can pretty much eliminate completely. With that being said though, this is still a man bag, and if you want to try to carry something like this, you should always own that fact, because there will be people that give you shit for it. But hey, enough of me blabbing, let's get into the bag itself. So this bag is roughly the same size as the small camera cube I use in my backpacks every now and then. It has a main compartment that is closed off with this big flap that is being held in place with a solid brass clasp and buckle. You could also unlash this the traditional way if you'd want to, but it's certainly faster the other way. The buckle is still useful to give you a bit more space in the main compartment though. The wax canvas is water repellent, and the bag has side rain flaps for a minimum of protection. I still wouldn't advise you to haul this through a rainstorm, since it's still easy to touch your gear even when the bag is fully closed. The main compartment is just that, and as stated previously, it comes with just a single divider, so the other one you see in here is one of my own. It has tiny side pockets on the outside and two stash pockets in the front under the lid. Also, there is a wider open pocket for easy access on the back, and that's it. The shoulder strap looks and feels like some kind of seatbelt material, with brass clamps and leather attachment points on either end. It's easily comfortable enough in my opinion, especially for a small bag like this. The main compartment is obviously well padded on the sides and also on the bottom, which on the outside is actually also only made from wax canvas, unlike the MagSatch 11, which sports a very durable leather bottom. But anyway, let me now show you how I've set this bad boy up. First, the main compartment. In here, you'll find my EDC camera of choice, which is still the Fuji X100V. I do have the square hood V adapter mounted to the front of the lens right now, and also a polarizer, which is why I wasn't able to fit the actual lens hood. Most of the time though, I simply have a UV filter on there to get that extra bit of weather protection and use it with the lens hood. Anyway, if you are interested in my opinion on this glorious camera, feel free to check out my 1 year review linked in the description below. Next to the Fuji, you'll find the Sony vlogging tripod thing that came with my ZV-1. It's honestly not something I'd buy with my own money, but it's nice to have nonetheless. When it's folded up, it fits into the bag no problem, and it's easy enough to attach and detach to any of my travel cameras to keep around at all times. So yeah, if that's something that you're into, it might be worth checking out. Wedged in the middle, I keep my Maxpedition Micro Pocket Organizer. This organizer is made from very durable 800D nylon with a big YKK zipper. I bought it 4 years ago and have carried it almost daily, and it still looks brand new. In this organizer, I try to keep as many of the essential items as I can, while still remaining a somewhat flat profile.
So in here, going from left to right, I keep a USB to lightning cable to recharge my phone from my power bank, a USB A to USB-C cable to charge my Fuji, and a lightning SD card reader for on-the-go file transfer in case Bluetooth doesn't work for some reason. On the right, I keep a Lumentop FW3A in polished aluminium. This little monster pumps out over 2000 lumens of light and offers a metric ton of functionality. Also, with the warmer Nichia emitters, it gives a warmer light that is very pleasing to the eye. Good stuff. Last but not least is my Leatherman Juice S2. This is a small to medium sized multi-tool that Leatherman has apparently discontinued, so if you can find one somewhere, make sure to snack it up while you still can. In my opinion, it offers all the functionality I will ever need in my day-to-day life, from a small slip-joint Warncliffe blade to the bottle and can opener, a big pair of spring-loaded scissors, a Phillips and various flathead screwdrivers, to a big enough for most use cases set of pliers. All in a fairly small package that is legal to carry almost everywhere that is not an airplane or a government building. The color choices and textures are questionable at best, so I wouldn't mind seeing an aesthetically enhanced version 2 of this, but in terms of functionality, it's a wonderful tool. In the rear of the organizer, I keep an assortment of caffeine pills and anti-diarrhea pills, as well as ibuprofen. Just in case bad times strike while I'm out and about, I don't want to be caught off guard. So that's the Maxpedition Micro Pocket Organizer. A lot of utility in a very small and durable package. Next item in my bag is this Stanley flask, which I use as a small water bottle. It holds up to 250 milliliters of fluid, and you're guaranteed to draw some attention when you whip this guy out in a public park or at work at 10 a.m. to drink a sip of refreshing water. In that sense, it might not be the best choice, but the form factor is just too good not to take advantage of. All the way over to the right, I keep my Sony ZV-1 with the newly acquired Ulanzi Ultra Wide Angle adapter on it. With this adapter added onto the front of the lens, the ZV-1 can go up to 18 mm wide, at least without the 4K or active stabilization crop. But even with both of these, it's still wide enough for my on-the-go filming needs. I use it in 1080p with active stab on most of the time, so I get a fairly wide field of view while still maintaining good quality and limiting shakes. If you're interested in the ZV-1, feel free to check out the video I made about it just a few weeks ago. In the front right pouch, I store my filter organizer. This can house up to 3 filters at a time, but since I only have 3 filters and keep one on my Fuji at all times, the third slot is free to be used to store the mini tool I need to screw the square hood lens hood on and off, as well as the bottom cap of the Ulanzi wide angle adapter. In the other pouch, I keep a flat intensive power bank that holds a maximum charge of up to 5000 mAh and has an integrated micro USB cable. Behind the power bank, I keep a Moleskine notebook in A6 and a brass Caveco Lilliput pen. The pen is an absolute delight to write with. It looks amazing in my opinion, takes on a nice patina, and has a surprising amount of weight to it. The refills are fairly inexpensive, and the whole construction is robust. So overall, I consider this to be the perfect on-the-go pen. And that concludes the main storage areas of this bag. The side pockets are tiny, as you can see, but there is still enough space to store a pack of paper tissues on one side, and spare batteries for both of my cameras on the other. Last but not least, there is a big flat open pocket on the back that I use to store my mask for easy access, because this is the world we live in, I guess, as well as a foldable bag to carry groceries or whatever in case the need arises.
And that's it. In my opinion, this small bag is able to carry a lot of items, but if I ever needed to carry bigger items, like extra jackets or snacks or more water or whatever you might think of, I will ditch this immediately, as I said previously, and go for something like a hiking bag or my EDC backpack. For the summer months though, when we just go to the local farmer market or a restaurant or a cafe or whatever, I think this bag is pretty much exactly what I need. It carries all the things and all the essentials I need and nothing more. It's easy to carry, it doesn't build up sweat on my back, it doesn't get in the way, so it's pretty much perfect for what it is. And also, I think, fingers crossed, if we are able to and allowed to travel this summer, this bag will probably be what I will carry with me for whatever trip we might come up with. So let me know what you think about this loadout. Do you have any recommendations for items you think I should check out? And what do you think about the whole man bag situation overall? Anyway, that's it for today though. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, take care. Bye.